My name is Lauren O'Connell, and welcome to my honest experience with electrolysis. As you can see, I have no makeup on right now, just my skincare and of course my SPF. And that's because I really want you to take a good look at my skin and the hair on my face throughout this video. I am 37 years old with dry skin. In today's video, I'm going to share with you what electrolysis is and why I chose to get this treatment. I'll also share with you what clinic I went to, what the experience was like, as well as my results, and of course the question I'm sure you're curious about: was it painful? Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and you hit that notification bell so you never miss any of my upcoming videos. My videos help you to become a more informed consumer because I dive deep into the ingredients going into our skincare, cosmetics, hair care, and dental products. I also love to share treatments. This is my second treatment video. I do have one on picogenesis. Now let's get into the electrolysis. And electrolysis is the permanent hair removal treatment for all hair types. During electrolysis, a probe is placed into your hair follicle and a filament sends a current down and it destroys the growth cells of your hair. I chose to get this treatment done because I was sick and tired of getting my upper lip waxed or using a hair removal cream. Both of those treatments resulted in me getting burns, dry skin, and just irritated skin. I also am not a candidate for laser because laser needs to have dark hair. There needs to be melanin in the hair for the light to grab onto and turn to heat to then destroy the hair follicle. So for me, electrolysis seemed like the best choice, and I am so happy I went on this journey. Electrolysis is a marathon, not a sprint. And that's because we have a lot of hair, especially on our faces. And with electrolysis, you do have to go hair by hair. Also, our hair grows in different cycles. There's actually three different cycles of hair growth. The anagen cycle is when the hair is actually growing. The catagen cycle is the intermediate phase to the telogen phase. And the telogen phase is when the hair falls out. So for example, when you're in the shower and you lose hair, that hair was in the telogen phase. It's best to do electrolysis when the hair is in the anagen phase, although sometimes some of the hair may not be, so that particular hair may need another session of electrolysis. The biggest risks with electrolysis are infection, and that can happen if you're going to a clinic that's not sanitary or not using sterile techniques, as well as scarring. And that can happen if your technician is not properly trained. It's so important to be confident in the clinic you're going to so you can also be very comfortable. And that's why I chose to go to Furless Permanent, and this is not a sponsored video. I just want to share with you my experience with electrolysis. I did like Furless here in Dubai because it is incredibly sanitary. I felt very confident in the technicians there, and I'm also a nurse. I do have a master's degree in nursing, so I do have quite a scrutinizing eye when I'm looking around at different clinics, and for me, it was up to my standards, and my standards are quite high. I started going to the clinic last spring and I received a series of treatments. I think I went about 6 or 7 times. Every single time I went, it was the same treatment. So I would get there, I would lay down on the bed, and my upper lip area was then sterilized with an alcoholic swab. I then was ready for the treatment, and the technician would place the probe onto my skin into each different hair follicle and remove the hair with a tweezer. Now, I have to be honest with you, and the first time I went, I had so much anxiety about the pain. I had built it up in my head that it was going to be right next to childbirth, and I could not have been more wrong. The first time I laid on that bed, I was so rigid and I was just ready for the worst. And the technician did one little hair and I looked at her and I said, "That's it?" And she laughed and said, "Yes." And I felt like the biggest baby. So I have to tell you, the pain on a scale of 1 to 10, it's maybe a 0.25 for the majority of the hair. I did find that if I wasn't exactly feeling well, if I was feeling tired that day, if I was PMSing or in the midst of my cycle, then everything was more sensitive. And at that point, I would say maybe it was a 2.5 out of 10. If the most painful thing I've ever experienced in my life is childbirth, I've done it twice, and I would say that's the 10 out of 10. So the electrolysis really is barely anything. You can get a numbing cream put on the area that you're getting treated. However, I chose to just bypass that because it was so painless. The only time I did experience some pain, which I would put it to maybe a 3 out of 10, if that, was when I had the probe right on my lip line. Those ones I definitely felt more, but overall it was a pretty pain-free experience. And in a couple of my sessions, I did fall asleep. And in one session, I did do a guided meditation, which was wonderful. Each session was 30 minutes long, which was the perfect amount of time. And afterwards, I was treated with an ice cube and then some cream and, of course, SPF. When your skin undergoes electrolysis, you are going to be more sensitive to the sun. Of course, you know I tell you to wear SPF every single day, but make sure you especially put it on after electrolysis. I was told to not put on makeup for 24 hours after the treatment. However, that's just not possible. So I put on makeup afterwards right away and nothing ever happened. Everything was completely fine. These sessions were so easy to go to. I felt like I was in and out, took a quick nap. And as far as the results go, when you first get electrolysis, remember I did say it's a marathon, not a sprint, I didn't really notice anything different. It seemed like there was a little bit less hair on my upper lip, but it wasn't until the summertime when I was back home in the USA and I was putting on my makeup one day and I thought to myself, I have not thought about the hair on my upper lip in so long. It used to be one of those things I would constantly have to maintain. And although the hair was blonde, it was still noticeable. And I just almost forgot that I ever had it. And that's when I realized, wow, the electrolysis really works. And it does take a few months, I think, to really see the difference and to acknowledge it and to notice it. But I could not believe it. And I have not had to use any cream, any waxing since. I have had one more session, which I got in December, and it was just a tune-up session. I do still have some hair there, so it's not all completely removed, but it is so minimized to the point that I never ever think about it. And you can see that there is a big difference between the hair on my cheek area, because you can see all that blonde hair, versus the hair on the upper lip. It's just less. So if you are thinking about electrolysis, I say go for it. Do at least one session to see what it feels like. And of course, make sure that that clinic you go to is sanitary, sterile, and you feel confident in the clinic. If you are in Dubai, I highly recommend going to Furless Permanent. I've had such a great experience there. It's worked wonders for me, and I could not possibly be happier. Thanks again for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I look forward to seeing you again very soon. Bye-bye. Thank you for watching. Subscribe now to Lauren O'Connell Beauty TV, and let's navigate together through the world of beauty.